Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to show you how to install the new Catalyst 8000B Virtual Edge Router from Cisco. It's a pretty simple install. It's a very new offering from Cisco that is pretty exciting. One of the things about this new router is that it can be installed either on VMware ESXi or on cloud platforms such as AWS or Azure. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to install on ESXi, as you can see from the vSphere interface that I have up here. So with no further ado, we're going to go ahead and take care of this install. It doesn't take very long. So I'm going to go ahead and get our OVA. Drag it over there, give it a name. And next. We've got a couple of choices. We see that there are three interfaces, which you can set to different ones. I'm just going to leave the same one just for sake of installation and brevity. And deployment type, we have small, medium, and large for both 8 gigabyte disk or 16 gigabyte disk, including a large plus DRAM upgrade that increases it to 8 gigabytes of RAM. That is a different SKU, a different purchase, which you will have to take care of in licensing. And the difference between the small, medium, and large has to do with mostly the virtual CPUs and how many of those you're going to use. I'm just going to use a small one since this is a small lab environment. We're going to leave the power on automatically to go ahead and take care of that. And every single time I have installed this, I've come up with this problem of the duplicate element instance ID, but I just go back and next again, and it is fine. So if you run into that, don't worry about it. It is okay. And finish, and then we're going to go ahead and take care of that. And the installation is done. It takes about 5 minutes for it to complete, for the VMware portion of it, and then for it to come up fully. So we are now in and we have a router prompt. And so I'm going to show you a few things that are the default configuration of the router when it's installed. And then I'm going to go ahead and configure it so that we can log into it, SSH, and then to show you what that's all about. Okay, so let's take a look at the configuration. So we are on version 17.4, and we'll take a look at the AAA new model is set to no. So we're going to want to change that. Okay, we have a crypto certificate in there. However, there is no RSA key for SSH, so that's something that we're going to need to take a look at. Our interfaces, we have the three interfaces, and one of them is automatically set for DHCP, so it's automatically going to go out and get an IP address. Okay, gigabit one is set to shut down, gigabit three is not set to shut down but doesn't have an IP address and no DHCP. All right. And then that's pretty much it. And then we've got our line VTY04, which has automatically login and transport import SSH on it. So to take care of what we need to be able to log in, we need a few things. One is we need a host name. So we're going to give it a host name of cat8000v1. Oh, we need to go into config T to do that. All right, hostname cat 8000v1. Okay, we need a domain name. SSH, we need a domain name. And we need to turn on that a new model. Okay, we need an enable password. And nobody share my secret, super secret password there. And we need a username. And then finally, we're going to generate the RSA key. That's power 2048, which is good. And that's it. We are done. Go ahead and write that configuration. Now we need to take a look and see what IP address we got on that DHCP. And we got .90. All right, so we're going to go ahead and SSH into there. And ask for our SSH fingerprint. Yes. And our super secret password. And enable. And there we go. We are logged in. All right. And we can see there's login success. So we did it. So that's the installation of the Catalyst 8000V virtual edge router. If you like this video, go ahead and like and subscribe to my channel. I'm going to have many more videos of this, things like this in the collaboration space. I'm going to take a look at things such as installing cube configuration for the 8000V. Maybe even looking at the HA configuration. We're going to see if we can install it on AWS. We're going to do a lot of things like that. So subscribe so you can get notifications. And if you have any issues or problems, comment below. Or if you just like the video, comment below and let me know what you think. And we'll see you next time.